Hello, and welcome to another episode. In this episode, I'd like to discuss collimation of SCTs. This is actually a worry for a lot of people, and they don't like to do it. But in fact, it's quite simple. However, I would like to point out that it's best to not use what many recommend, which is to do against a star, and instead to use an artificial star, such as this. This allows you to collimate your telescope inside your house and not have to try and do it in the dark outside, which makes everything a lot easier. So the first thing you want to do is to put your artificial star as far away as you can from your telescope inside your house, and then point the telescope at the artificial star and try and line it up in your eyepiece. Then you want to try and make an airy disc by slowly moving the focus so that it's out of focus, and so you can see like a blurred star, like a circular blur around it. Then you want to look for where the largest bulge is, and you want to sharpen up this side or let it in or let it out. And to do that, first of all, you need to put an object across the front of the telescope, such as your finger, and you'll see this come through on the image. Now, if it's closest to, once you find the one that's closest to the bulge, you either need to let it in or let it out. And I usually turn the screw about an eighth of a turn, and then I'll do the opposite direction for the other two screws. And so you keep on doing this until you've managed to flatten it out, as you can see in this footage here. Now, one useful tip when adjusting it or collimating an SCT is to actually use these. These are called Bob's knobs. You want to replace the screws found in this metal disc here, the secondary mirror, with these knobs here. And you should do that one at a time. Once you've done that, it allows you to adjust the collimation a lot more easily because they are larger and easier to use. And you don't have to use a screwdriver or Allen key right next to the delicate glass you don't want to scratch. Well, I hope you find that useful. If you've got any questions, please do leave them below. If you like the video, give it a like. And if you'd like to see more astronomy videos, then please do subscribe. Goodbye and clear skies.